So I'm going to specify the grid points by going under two-point input. And that brings up a calculation point dialog box. Here you want to specify the point spacing, left to right and top to bottom. 2 feet is a good spacing that I want for a space of this size, but you can increase it or decrease it. The text size of 0.6 feet seems to look good, again, in a space of this size, so I'll leave it to that. The other important option that you need to set is under the add grid option. Here you want to specify the height of the work plane relative to the floor of the model by changing the first point and the second point of the Z coordinates. Hence, if the space is a conference room, the work plane height would be, you know, 2.5 feet above the floor. In my case, it's around 2.7 feet high. So that's what I've set up here. If it's an auditorium, the height would be 1.5 feet above the floor level. So once you've set up these two main criteria, the other things you can go with default, or you could look into the software user guide to understand some more options. But this is the illumination calculation grid that we are plotting on our plan. So click OK, and then specify the 2 points which would show the boundary of the calculation point. And as soon as you click on those 2 points, it starts to show the grid. You can look at it under one of the isometric views or even an elevation view. So you'll notice that my calculation points are placed right above the conference table. Once you've done that, then it's a matter of just clicking on calculate to find out the amount of illuminance that's received at each of these points. And it's going to show you the initialization window, and it's going to take a while to compute this. Again, it depends on the complexity of the geometry in your model. Once the calculations are complete, you can see the foot candle levels at different points in the space, and here we can see it at the plan view.